The Minister of Kampala, Hajat Minsa Kabanda, and officials from the Kampala Capital City Authority witnessed the signing of a memorandum of understanding between Nachivubo Blue Primary School and the Japanese government today. The Japanese government gave a grant of 500 million shillings towards the construction of new classroom blocks at Nachivubo Blue Primary School in Kampala. Kabanda commended the Japanese government and assured them of proper use of the 500 million shillings, especially considering the dense population of a school.
Here we are going to make good use of it. We are going to take good care of it. We have the best headmistress in Kampala. May I call her the best headmistress because I trust her and I know how the school is densely populated.
The head teacher of Nachivubo Blue Primary School, Agnes Mugisha, noted that the construction will align with the concept of a smart city.
Very glad and excited because we are going to get a bigger space. There are only two rooms, but we are going to get five, right? We are going to get five, and it is going to also to congest our classrooms.
The mayor of Kampala Central, Saleh Muhuru, pledged to ensure proper maintenance of the classrooms, emphasizing their essential nature and assuring that there would be value for money.
Thank you for loving us as Ugandans and those projects, especially where you told me you're going to Arua.
Yes, from tomorrow.
For another opening of a school.
Yes.
Thank you so much, and we are behind you.
The Japanese ambassador to Uganda reiterated the commitment to always give a hand towards the improvement of the country's education sector, among others.
About this project is that the local government or the school's health center contacts us directly, and every year we receive around 300 to 400 applications. 300 to 400 applications. But we can only do 8, 9, 10 projects per year.
The construction of the classrooms is expected to last for a year. Situated downtown Kampala, Nachivubo Blue Primary School is one of the oldest schools in Kampala, where most of the children from the low-income earners study from. Story compiled by Juliet Namuaya for the news.